Everybody, hope you're doing well in your bubbles. This week's activity is following on from last week, and it's also using nature and to get a feel for our environment, where we live, our sense of home. And we're going to look at an artist named John Wolseley. He's Australian, and he literally immerses himself into the landscape, into nature, and uses natural materials to make art. So often his art won't just look like the place he's been to, it'll have the smells and the sense of the place as well. So let's dive into that. On our site, of course, you'll be able to see other links that will be little clips about his work and the man himself and his process. So you'll see all everything that he does. Here I've just got a little slide share that you can see. It's a little clip of little photos of him actually working, and he walks through the landscape with a massive, massive piece of paper, and it's all been through, like, it's a forest fire. So when he drags his paper across, he gets interesting marks on the page. He also does a lot of pressing on actual leaves and things from the landscape, little bits of roots and stuff like that. And that leaves an impression, and he might leave them like that for weeks, months, years even. And then when he takes everything off again, it's left like an impression or the marks as well. And he also uses soil and water from lakes and things and wetlands that he makes the art about. I think that's it. Oh no. And then he'll work back into it and draw back into it, sometimes adding a bit more watercolour. So today, we are going to use some of those things in your garden, maybe, if you've got permission from Mum and Dad. I went with my children and we went around and collected things. So all you'll need is a pencil, some description, an old box to put, or a container to put leaves and things in that you find. So here you can see we collected all sorts. A feather, lovely green leaves, pine needles, which actually could use as a bit of a brush even. John Wolseley does that. Bits of bark. If you've got any old leftovers from old fires and things, you can actually use that to draw with. And we found lavender. Smells beautiful. So if you use that in your artwork, that sense of smell will be right throughout your work. A strawberry, which was amazing. What the goats didn't eat. Good old dandelion. Amazing pigments in dandelion. All of the paints and things that you use, they contain pigments, and that's the colour. And often these pigments come from natural sources. The other thing, we live on a hillside and it's very clay-based soil, and that's an amazing, amazing thing to draw with. So let's see what my kids and I found. What you can do first of all is go out, get your box of things, and while you're out there as well, do a few rubbings with a pencil. So get your pencil, here's some leaves that I've got kawa kawa, and most of you will know how to do a rubbing, but those that don't, you'll need to get your paper, put your leaf under the paper. So if you've just got one piece of paper, you just go and put it on top of whatever surface interests you, like whether it's a leaf or a bit of bark from a tree, and use the side of your pencil lead and do a rubbing. Okay, so this is how you do that, side of the pencil, no tip, just the side. So then the camera person. This pencil needs to be sharpened a bit. Oh, there we go. Should pick up all the little veins in the leaf. You get the idea? It's quite exciting, really. Etching or rubbing technique
it's been used for a long time, especially cool when you go to a plaque or an old, even like an old stone plaque where you can't read the writing anymore. A lot of people use this to pick up what the text says. So you might even have things around your home, like the numbers on your letterbox or the cladding on your house that you can do a rubbing off, and that can be part of your art as well as natural things. Okay, so that's that one, and you know that you're only limited by your imagination. Love kawakawa. Okay, I had a feather as well. So what I would suggest you do is get your box of things, go out, have a test on some test paper and get a few ideas together. And then when you've got a bit of an idea, label things too. Like you can see there, I've got like bark, strawberry leaf, a fern. I actually got the paper and rubbed it on the lawn and that picked up that. That red was from a flower. It was had amazing pigment. I couldn't believe it. There's my clay. Pumpkin seed, just from a pumpkin that we ate. There's a bit of it there the other night. And so get your collection of things and then start your art. When you start your art, I would suggest you just do what I did. And you just make a couple of etchings of things that interest you. So I've got a feather here. Might put that over there. So yeah, just go along with your pencil and do an etching of a couple of items. So you've got that. It's an interesting base. I really needed to sharpen this pencil because then I would have picked up some more of those little fibers. Try and get as much of that detail as I can get. Longer, but because I know that you want to get on with it, I won't take up too much more of your time here. I've actually made one earlier to show you. So you know, got a bit of an impression of things. Then you could try things like wetting your paper. You don't even need a brush for this, but this is what Wolseley does. He just uses the water from the lakes where he's trying to make art to get capture that sense of place, and then he will work into it with things from nature. So this is it in my garden. I've sacrificed a little miniature Pūtikawa bloom. Pretty cute. Let's see what happens when I actually rub it. So nothing at first. Oh yeah, just falling to bits. Give it time. Get some really interesting marks. And the pigment of those red blooms, amazing. Woo! It's a really cool energy, pinky red. The idea is that you get some wonderful marks on your page. Don't worry about it looking like anything because we want to capture the sense of it. Dust it off. The other thing to be careful of is if you've got a white bench like me, you don't want to stain it, just have a cloth ready. Okay, so I was going to use my clay next. This will crumble and go everywhere. That's cool. Lovely ochre colour. And actually, ochre paint, this is why this natural pigment they use is from clay. I need some water on that now. So you can actually use a brush if you want and just turn it into. You could even use like a little piece of scrap paper and make a little puddle and dip it in and actually paint something if you wanted to. I quite like it looking natural, just like the place that I've been in. See how that works on top of the wet? Now another really nice yellow pigment that is everywhere, especially if you haven't been mowing your lawn. Yeah, dandelion. Oh, where'd it go? Here it is. I've got a bit of a leftover dandelion. They have a beautiful yellow. Let's see if I can get some green off one of my green leaves. This one doesn't want to give up its green. Maybe the calla. Well, that's a nice green, look at that. Wow. Oh, that's from our lime tree. It smells amazing. Now, one thing I will say is don't go getting plants that are noxious, like toadstools. Leave them well alone. We've got plenty growing around us at the moment, and I wouldn't let anyone touch those. In fact, my son did touch one, and I made him go and wash his hands straight away. And here, if you guys have one of these, you could even grind up some of the leaves. Make sure you wash it after too. You could grind up the leaves, and you could add a little bit of methylated spirits to break it down, or just a little bit of oil. John Wolseley went to a lake and he actually used the moss, the sphagnum moss it's called, that's kind of growing in the water, and he just left his art, he pressed it into his art and it made amazing patterns. Another thing he did was he just left his paper in the dirt and the roots all grew around it and left marks. Sometimes he'll leave the artwork to blow around in the wilderness for up to a year and then he'll go and find it again. Oh, here's a strawberry. A bit more fluorescent. Looks amazing. Looks great with the ochre tones. It's got a bit of a waxy vibe and... oh, it smells really sweet. Okay, so I'm gonna have a bit more of a play with this. I do have one here somewhere that I made. Where did it go? Another one that I made. Just kept adding layers and layers until I liked what I was seeing. And then you can work back into it and draw and write through it and all sorts. But yeah, I'll let you guys go ahead and have a play and we'll see what you come up with.